Hello guys, and welcome back to our GeoGuessr challenge. I am Elmo.
I'm Tuna.
And so if you haven't seen this before, so basically we'll jump on a map, we will race against, well, not race against each other, but we'll try and get the most points over the five rounds that you have. And we've been doing this in quite a few. Tuna, you know what score it is?
I do.
What's the score?
Good question.
I thought you just looked it up.
It's 6-2 to me. I won five rounds of the UK, you won one. I won on Mongolia, and you won the last one, which was Luxembourg.
So what we've been doing is we're going on all legit GeoGuessr maps at the moment, and we are at, so I've got a wheel that I'll put up on the screen in a moment, and it has got all the maps that are left. There's 100 left. We have taken off Russia for obvious reasons, and we've taken off all the maps that we have done. There is some maps that aren't countries but are actual cities. So Paris and London is in there. There might be a couple other big cities in the world as well on that map.
Just anything that's an official GeoGuessr map, basically.
Yeah. If it's a big country, like United States or whatever country, we will decide then whether we are going to do five best of five. If it's a smaller country or smaller place or just a place that we think is going to be really difficult, we might just do best of one. Like we did with Mongolia and Luxembourg. So we are going to spin the wheel. Oh, let's spin and see. Sweden.
Okay. Fun fact, it's where GeoGuessr was born and raised.
Ah.
I'm not reading this off their official page.
No. Play, challenge, invite friends, location tuner, and as soon as I click start game, it will start and send you an invite. So I shall see you again very, very soon.
I will see you when I'm victorious.
Bye. Okay, so we are off. So, this is, so we're over a railway, which kind of helps, could do with being down there. Yeah, we can jump down there, so we can see, get some places. So I don't actually know Sweden that well. That map's way too big. So, let's see, I know Stockholm, Gothenburg, but it's more up here that if we end up being up here, that's when I'm probably going to struggle. So I don't really recognize any of them places. So let's see if we can see some of them. Get an early advantage. Sandvinken now, software. Linders, can we see a Linders anywhere? Paul's Krona. They all just look like IKEA sets. I might have to zoom in a bit more. I'm hoping that I don't have to zoom in too much. Just because it takes longer to find it, but don't want to spend too much time on the roads if I can help it, just because I don't think it's going to... Well, I've got this big clue here with these places. I think it'd be wasting a lot of time going to find a bigger clue. Any Swedish people watching this? Do you know any of these places? It's Sweden's a place that I want to go and visit. So, if you are from Sweden, feel free to drop me any recommendations on places to visit. Obviously, there's the common tourist places to go and visit, but if you can recommend somewhere better to go and visit as a tourist rather than where everybody goes, then I'm up for that. That's Sweden as well. I need to take that into account. I'm not seeing anything standing out. I'm still in Sweden, aren't I? Yeah. I don't know if it'll be worth going down the road trying to find some bigger clues or not. These could be the biggest clues that I'd have in like a couple of mile radius. But try not to go too far away from Stockholm to start with. Bit to the south, because I think more of it will be down south. Could be wrong. Nybro, there we are. Nybro's 30 miles away. I think it's miles or kilometers. There's Nybro, so where... There's other places. Linders is down here as well, somewhere. And then the opposite direction is Tingsrid. So if I can find Tingsrid, then I'm kind of in between the two. Don't know the distance on the map. It doesn't show you on here. Still can't find Tingsrid. Karlskrona's down here. So I think Tingsrid's there. Right, so kind of got... So we're in the middle here. Sodre... I'm probably butchering any of these places, so I do apologise. So Nybro, Karlskrona. So I think we're going to be around here somewhere, maybe. Linda's and Centrum, if I can find them, I think we're close to them. Linda's. Put myself down there for now. Look at the Sodra. Sodra Torsbow. Sodra 2. Is Sodra 2, is that the distance or is that the place? Is Sodra place? Okay. There's a lot of Sodras. Okay, so where is that place? Emma Bodamobla. What we got here? The 120 to Nebro, so that's going that way. Boulder. This Emma Boulder Mobler. There's a train thing there. So we was on a bridge over the train line. I think we might have been here. Just don't know where that Emma Bowden. Oh, actually. Oh, we could have been there then. Yeah. Was there. Okay. Good start, good start. Right, so we're going up quicker here. Let's go up here. So we're on the E4 here. Yeah. Gotta be some road signs because there's some big turn-offs here, so. Oh, this is awful. Gilgrey, you need to come back here. Need to get this done again. Sciencey. Stockholm. 366 miles, that doesn't help at all. Sixty-six miles away. Why do we need to know that? Right. That didn't help at all. The pace that we're going up this road isn't helping either. That's better. Picking up some speed now. Slowing down. Wunderbaumen. We're on the E4 somewhere. Galstrom. Have I seen Galstrom? I feel like I've seen that somewhere. Maybe not. Galstrom. Wait, I didn't follow E4P, did I? No, I didn't. I could have been looking in a completely wrong place. I was. I think went all the way up here all along. And it ends there. God's sake. Right. Could have been here. Goldstone's book. Where's that? That needs to be around here somewhere then. And it's not. Where's Angom? Luwuden. Thinking that I'm there, I'm here. Sounds we got down here. Sundsvall, 16 miles. Yeah, so that's the 2-2-2. I'm going to put myself there. Yeah, close enough. I lost 3 points, but he should have lost maybe 3-4 points. Okay. All right. Like an industrial place. Yeah, what's this? Means nothing. Oh, got a big lager shop. Net on net. Got Mercedes. So these places wouldn't be near, you know, like in the middle of nowhere. You're not going to have like a small town miles away from a beige city that's going to have a Mercedes. Surely. And they're building some other things as well. Weren't that on one of the other maps? Got a feeling it was. Net on net gods. You'll see gods up there. So if we go around here, we should see some biggish city names or place names, hopefully. Since we've got, around here. Stockholm. So we're in the E4 again, it looks a bit. Helsingborg and Stockholm. So we must be up here somewhere to be heading down there. Vastavik. Dixval, that's what I was looking for last time. And Sundsvall. Doesn't actually say how far away we are from Stockholm and Helsingborg. Let's have a look what we've got on this same round here. Vestavik's got an airport, so Vestavik should be quite big. E4, Ross Vic, Lung Vic, are the Vics up here? Hang Vic? Is Vastavik up here though? Go back on this roundabout, see what other places we've got. I think I can go that way. What sound have we got up here? That's what I've already seen. on this side. They're not really helping me. E4th. Junction 3. Is that Junction 34? Will that help me? We're up here, so. Is that 34? Junction, maybe? Seven nine. So maybe not then. Unless it's that road that it means. Unless it means leading onto another road. That goes on to 77. I might be completely wrong with this then. Okay. 292, so I don't think it is. I'm 76, maybe. Three or three, maybe not. Probably is a rhyme and reason to all these, but oh, that's 83. That's gone off onto 83. There'll be another one up here that's like 250. I need 34 though. No, I don't think I'm right with that logic. I've seen no blue numbered roads now. That's putting into that logic. Might be right, but it's just not found here. Okay. Spending far too much time on this. I'm just seeing the same places. We're still in Sweden. Oh, we are. They've still got miles to go. Okay. It could still be a thing then. Didn't realize how much zoomed in. I've traveled for miles up here. 90. I don't think it's working. It's still not a thing. E12 now. Is this it? Are we? No, we've still got miles to go. So where's E4 gone? Let's see. It continues. The LI numbers. So me looking for 34 just seems a bit pointless. Seems like it's not going to be a thing. 94. I think 8 is the lowest that we've gone. To the end of the E4 now. And I wasn't even looking at place names. I really need to. Found 35 finally. Is this where I am? Link ping's not on here. Airport there. I hope Tune is struggling on this as much as I am. No, he hasn't finished yet. Lingam. Closer than that place. On that, up be there. Oh, wow. That's before that were built. Okay. Down here. Tombi. I'll build it. Around this area, is the Tombi place though? I'm going to put myself down here. Have you seen anything about Link Ping though? What's this down here? Oh, that's the net. That net. Bog shop, and then what's this? BMW. Watch as well, is it? BMW. There. Just gonna pause there. Yeah, I can't be asked to argue with that. Right. Tune is done. Get out of this place to find where we could be. Centrum. I don't know what centrum means. I need to find out what centrum means, but it's, I don't think it's a place. So I think I've seen it a lot. E4. God, I'm sick of seeing E4. Is this the main road? Google car, I've only been to E4 road. So what places have we got here? Carlsborg. Up Carlsberg following the E4 route without zooming in too much. If not, then I'm going to go down the road a bit. Not that. Oh, Leah. Oh. Aparanda, is that here as well? That's 8 to 2 miles, so I think we might be up here somewhere then. Aaliyah's there. So 8 to 2 miles in one direction is 89 miles in one direction is going to be Carlsborg. Well, 7 miles is Aparanda. So if we find Aparanda, I can try and find in the middle. I don't know how far 100 miles is on the map. Down here, what's where I need to find where I am now. That's what I need. York's Falls. York Sally. York Land. No, I can't, I haven't seen Apparanda yet, so let's go further down here. I'll come until Calyx. Is Calyx. Can't rule off it being up here somewhere. Calyx there. Calyx is there. How many characters is there? The Oaks Falls. Right, okay. What's where Calyx is? Calyx is, there's a Calyx here. There's also a Calyx here. Right, so there's Calyx something. Then we're going to try and pronounce that. So I'm just going to go, I think I'm just going to go here somewhere. Wiedervigen. Wiedervigen. Edvigan. Wiedervigen. Just gonna That was a dead end. And then I turn out of Vita Wagon. I'm just going to plant myself there. Yeah. Okay, so last one. Is this an easy one, please? Doesn't look like it. Main route, so I'm going towards this. Instead, score up. This is going to give me different information, but I'm still going to look at it. Gusnava. There's not even much point. Go this way. Come on. E65. E45. 22. E45, that's the highest that I've seen. No, E65. E65, okay. Gusnava. What's the other places? That's just taking me to the E65. Westbergaard. Weistad. This is... small place, so. I believe we're around here somewhere. Go back down here. Oh. Come on. I start and score up. Score up. So we're in between there. Carlsborg. Looking for that gross place. Gusnava. The hell's Gusnava? We're playing Scorp on Wystad. Yeah, different opposite directions. So between them, there's Gusnava. Where is Gusnava? Surely it's around here somewhere. Can't give him too many points. I think he's won anyway, but can't give him too many points. fuck off. Oh,
hello.
Don't like it.
Yeah, I sort of I don't fancy that best of three anymore.
I focus far too much on roads and spent far too much time going up and down the map on said roads, mainly E4.
Yep.
And the last one, I've just spent far too long looking for a place that doesn't exist.
It was a lot harder than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, definitely. Are you ready to view summary? And I already know the result, but...
I'm ready.
Go. I'm now a traveller, so I've gained a new title. Game breakdown. Yeah.
That's closer than I expected.
I was behind anyway, but I threw it away big time on that last one.
Yeah, you had a 1 point advantage after round two, which turned into 1 point for me. Which turned into 3 points for me, and then, yeah, that last one.
Yeah. It was doing meddling. So I was looking for a place called Gusnava because there was a sign for Gusnava.
Yep, I was also looking for that.
But I can't find Gusnava on the map.
Nope.
But I knew we was on the E65 between Skurup and Wystad. So I had just spent far too long looking round for this Gusnava place.
I figured out that the white signs were road names. So then once I saw the road that was called Gusnavegan.
So I did towards the end. I kind of figured out that they was road names, but I wasn't sure if, because it didn't look like a big road, I wasn't sure if it'd show on the map.
But then the road that we were actually on was differently named on the map. Well, it was on the sign. That's what threw me off. That's what took me so long on that one.
No, I saw Malmö Vegan on the street sign map.
Yeah, that was the main road, but we were opposite that on what was Marsvin's home, Stasenvag.
Well, yeah, so when I saw Malmö Vegan on one of those white signs, I'm like, well, surely it's not going to be this main road that we're on here. But E65, where's E64 and E63 and E62 and where's all the other E60s?
See, it didn't quite go as I expected, because I thought the lower numbers were like southeast and it went up. And generally they do, apart from that one. And obviously the E4, which goes the full length of the country.
I can't remember which one it was. It might be the first one or the second one. But I found E4. I'm like, oh, right. So that goes from Helsingborg to... So I followed it so far up until Norrköping. Or did I follow it? No, I didn't. Yeah, it might have been Norrköping. No, it wasn't. It was near Stockholm. Because then it goes to E20. E4 turns to E20, and I'm like, oh, okay, that's the end of E4 then. So I was going up and down that for a good 5-10 minutes. And then I'm like, no, it's not there. Surely E4 continues. And then I went further up through Stockholm. I'm like, wait a minute. I've been looking down south and it goes all the way up north.
I'm so annoyed I dropped points on that second one. But it was the fourth one, which took me ages. Because I found a sign that was for somewhere. I can't remember what it's called now. The fourth one.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I felt lucky on that one because I randomly saw a sign for Lilia, and I just so happened to see that. But then I knew that we was in between two places, but I didn't know which direction.
Well, I found one place that was on the sign. I found that pretty early on. It was a lot further south than where we actually were. And I couldn't find the other one anywhere. And that's what I kept searching for. And then I was... eventually, I came across somewhere that said Calix. Mm-hmm. And then that's when I managed to narrow it down. I managed to find Calix on the map. But I was travelling for miles on that one.
My hardest one was round two, and I think that's... Well, round three I was on for a long time as well. But round two, I think that's when I found out that E4 goes all the way up north.
I was so gutted. I've got points on that. So close to a perfect game.
Yeah, another win for you. But these can go either way, because you can either just like give up and just throw it down somewhere, or...
Which I very nearly did. Very nearly did on that fourth one.
I very nearly did on the fifth one. So, yeah, GG, dude.
It's a lot closer than I expected.
So we will be doing another one of these, but we don't spin the wheel until we are actually recording it, because then nobody can have the advantage of Googling, practicing, researching, and anything like that. So there's another 99 maps, and it's going to be very difficult to practice just in case you're on that map. So
and let's not forget, this was only like moderate difficulty.
Yeah. No time limit. You can move as much as you want. One thing that I did find annoying on this one, though, and I don't know if it was just me going down wrong roads.
At half the time, when you try and move, it goes like a frame at a time.
Yeah.
Oh my god, it was frustrating me so much.
So that's the thing. going in different countries, it depends how Google's done it, depends how often they've been there or how recent they've been there. Sometimes it could be older cameras, so I think Australia's, some of the places in Australia and some places in America are really bad for the quality of the images that they've got. So we could end up somewhere where it's just all sand. We could end up somewhere where it's major cities. Obviously, China's one of those places where there's not many places in China that have actually, Google have actually been, because they're not allowed.
Yeah.
So you're mainly in the big cities there. So who knows? We'll see where we are next time. But another win for Tuna. Well done on that one. I think you're going to win most of these, to be honest with you. But who knows?
I just need some of the train stations. I'm missing them.
I bet you are. Right. Join us next time. Don't forget to hit that link down below to see Tuna's version. See how he does it, because he definitely does it different.
And likewise on mine. Link down below to go and see Elmo's version. See how he went and figured some of them out. See if he has different methods to me.
There's no method to my madness. There's no madness. There's madness to my method. I've been Elmo. See you soon.
I've been Tuna. Bye-bye.
I've been dressing like an e-boy, long sleeve striped me boy, black shirt overseas boy, it's all a decoy. I wanna look so fine that you double tap twice and you always swipe right like an e-boy, long sleeve striped me boy, black shirt overseas boy, it's all a decoy. I wanna look so fine that you double tap twice and you always swipe right. See me looking sleepy with a beanie in the town, walking like a zombie, shambling around, always looking down cause I'm sad and